In this video, we are going to discuss about bearing capacity of soil and why we care about bearing capacity of a soil. We all know that all civil engineering structures, whether they are buildings, bridges, dams or tunnels, etc., are built on soil. Therefore, a foundation will be required to transmit the load of the structure on a large area of soil. Now, the term bearing capacity is the capacity of the soil to support the applied load that are acting on it. So, in the construction industry, this will mean the capacity of the soil to support building foundations. Just a quick reminder, if this is the first time you are coming across my channel, I make videos on civil engineering. So if you are interested in civil engineering videos, please do not hesitate to subscribe to my channel by hitting the red subscribe button below and also hit the bell notification icon so that you get notified when I upload a new video. You need to know that the foundation of a structure must be designed so that the soil does not fail in shape, because when this happens, the structure as a whole will fail quickly. And we all know what happened to elements that fail in shape. They tend to fail quickly without warning. So it is very important that the foundation does not fail in shape. Also, the foundation of a structure must be designed in order to avoid excessive settlement of the structure. Therefore, the conventional method of foundation design is based on the concept of bearing capacity. The bearing capacity of a soil can be calculated from the maximum average contact pressure between the foundation and the soil, which will prevent shear failure. Now, there are three modes of failure bearing capacity. The first one is general shear failure. The second is local shear failure, while the third is punching shear failure. There are also different bearing capacity which you need to take into consideration. The first is ultimate bearing capacity. The ultimate bearing capacity of a soil, which is designated as QU, is the maximum pressure the soil can support without failure occurring. The second is net ultimate bearing capacity. The net ultimate bearing capacity, which is designated as QNU, is the ultimate pressure per unit area of the foundation that can be supported by the soil in excess of the pressure caused by the surrounding soil at the foundation level. So, the net ultimate bearing capacity does not take into account the overburden pressure, and this can be calculated as the ultimate bearing capacity QU minus gamma multiplied by the depth of the foundation DF. The third is the net safe bearing capacity. The net safe bearing capacity, which is designated as QNS, takes into account only the shear failure, and this can be calculated as the net ultimate bearing capacity divided by a factor of safety. Finally, the allowable bearing capacity. The allowable bearing capacity, which is designated as QS, is the net load intensity at which no failure is experienced. So, the allowable bearing capacity is the ultimate bearing capacity divided by a factor of safety. So, these are the types of bearing capacity of soil. Now, if the bearing capacity of a soil at shallow depth is sufficient enough to safely take the load of the structure, then a shallow foundation should be provided. So, isolated footings, combined footing, or strip footing can be the option for the shallow foundation. Why? If the soil immediately below the structure does not have adequate bearing capacity, then you should use a deep foundation. So pipe, piers or well can be an option for the deep foundation. In case you want to know the method for determining the bearing capacity of soil, there are various methods and tests you can use. They are presumptive analysis, analytical method, plate bearing tests, penetration tests, modern testing methods, and finally, centrifuge test. So, this is the meaning of bearing capacity of soil and why we care about the bearing capacity of a soil. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and share these videos with friends. With that being said, see you all in my next video. Bye-bye.